This is Talk Business and Politics with Roby Brock.
And welcome to the program. I'm Roby Brock. Thanks for joining us this morning. The second congressional district race has heated up in the last 2 weeks with the two major party candidates airing some testy ads against one another. Republican French Hill was on the show a few weeks ago before the fireworks. Joining me this morning is Democratic candidate Pat Hayes. Welcome. Thank you for being here. Good morning. To see you as always.
Yeah, same here, Roby.
Let's talk about what's happening out on the campaign trail before we get into what's happening on the airwaves. What's the top issue, top two or three issues that you hear people talking about when they come up to you as you're working crowds in Pulaski County and the surrounding counties?
Well, obviously, jobs. And I know there was a report out today that the job percentages have been going in the right direction all over the state, literally. And so, you know, folks are concerned about, you know, their livelihood, their future, certainly their family, and what government can or can't do, should or shouldn't do in order to partner with them and making their lives better. And it's really the key number one item is jobs, a good quality job.
This week we saw some Republican and Democrats exchange emails. Democrats, particularly your campaign, talking about it's been the 1 year anniversary of the government shutdown. Mm-hmm. And then Republicans talking about it's been the 1 year anniversary of the botched healthcare.gov rollout. Which one are you celebrating this week?
Well, let me tell you what I'm celebrating this week. First of all, I'm celebrating my grandson's 6th birthday. I'm celebrating my granddaughter Isabella's 10th birthday. And that's what the government gave them a year ago for their birthday party. They shut down for 16 days.
That's what got you in the race,
that
really.
That was literally what really sort of tipped me over the scales. I mean, obviously I was thinking about it, but when I thought about those kids and Harper turning 5, now will turn 6 October the 8th, and thought about the fact that if he lives another 86 years, that he could, but he's 91 years old, and mm-hmm. that's, you know, would be quite a senior, but he could see the next century. And the rancor and the discord and the dysfunctionality and the lack of working together was such a contrast to what we did in North Little Rock and what we do in city halls all across the country. I just got angry and I got concerned about their future, the future of that generation, and decided that this was something that we just couldn't sit on the sidelines any longer.
Doesn't seem to be the boiling topic that it was a year ago, however, but one topic that is, it's been in the courts this week, it is certainly a key strategy for Democrats. You've been out front on this early, is mm-hmm. the minimum wage
sure.
increase. Are you worried that that's going to get kicked off the ballot?
You know, I wouldn't think so. I mean, you know, you had a Republican Secretary of State that certified the fact that they could file on Monday because of the 4th of July. You know, the courts, it's in front of the courts. I mean, I happen to have a little bit of a legal background. You know, it sure seems like that from an equity standpoint, certainly from the signatures on the petition and the effort that they went through, that initiative will be on the ballot. I would certainly hope so. I'd feel like the Supreme Court would come down on that side. At least that's my hope and desire, and certainly give the people of Arkansas a chance to vote on that. And over 60, almost maybe 70% of the people in Arkansas from a polling standpoint favor giving Arkansas a raise.
Right. So let's talk about, you mentioned the rancor that's out there in terms of political discourse right now at Washington, D.C. Down here, even locally, we're seeing it obviously across the airwaves.
Sure.
You were garnering quite a bit of positive press for several weeks for airing these very, very positive ads. And then about less than 2 weeks ago, French Hill comes out with an ad that says you've gone negative on him. You come out with an ad that takes him down a few notches here. Tell me why you felt like you had to come out with the ad that you came out with when you did.
Well, let me talk about, first of all, and I appreciate the compliment, I consider it one, that we had some ads that talked about our record, talked about balancing 24 budgets, talked about cutting our city's debt in half, talked about the quality of life issues that we had done. And then French came on and said, you know, that I had been attacking him, where I don't know that anyone could really figure where that came from. And then he proceeded to go into, you know, because I had a failed administration. Well, French, you know, 11, 12 days before I went out of office, presented me with an award on behalf of 50 for the Future that complimented me on the career that I had spent in contributing to the quality of life in Central Arkansas. You know, so, you know, I didn't have any desire to do anything other than talk about my record because I'm proud of it. And I think, you know, that's what I want to continue to talk about. But when someone makes some comments about you and your history and your record, you respond, and I did.
Let's pull up a little bit of what you said. I've got a pull quote here for what was in this ad that you ran. It was French Hill's best investment. French Hill and his fellow bank executives donated thousands of dollars to State Treasurer Martha Shoffner. It paid off big time. Shoffner directed $700 million to French Hill's bank. Do you really think that she directed $700 million to his bank because of a contribution that he made? That's the allegation that the ad insinuates.
Well, let me just say what we did was tell what the facts were. You know, the facts were contribution was made. The facts were that significant increase in business went to Delta Trust. The fact was Martha Shoffner, you know, was indicted and convicted. And the fact is that that significant amount of business has since fallen off. So all we felt the responsibility to do was just simply tell the facts, and that's what we did in the ad.
But do those facts connect? Do the dots connect? I mean, there's an insinuation there that because he made this contribution, he received this money from Martha Shoffner. It was a competitive bid process. You know how the banking process works on these bids. I know you've heard from some bankers on it, because I've heard from some bankers on it too. But is that fair game to present it the way that you presented it?
Well, I think when you present the facts, it is fair game, and that's all we did. We just talked about what took place during a certain period of time when business was being, we'll say, acquired, and I don't think there's anything wrong with presenting what the facts are in terms of the chronology of what took place.
You have had an ad running against you now from the French Hill campaign saying that you called Barack Obama the star quarterback, that you raised taxes 22 times to increase your salary. These may be facts, but are they insinuating something different?
Well, when it comes to 24 years in office, I started out working with George Bush number one. And then obviously went through the Clinton administration, and then Bush II, and then the Obama administration. When I go to Washington, it's going on behalf of issues that are important to the people of North Little Rock and the citizens that I represent. And it didn't make any difference which party was in Washington. I mean, 24 years, we covered two Democratic administrations and two Republican administrations. And so what we went to Washington for was what we could do as mayors, who are bipartisan. I mean, we're Democrat, Republican. You know, we don't care whether there's Democratic garbage or Republican crime. We just care about where there's problems and where they ought to be solved.
Well, to my point, though, if an attack ad's going to come against you, like an attack ad you've aired against your opponent, and it basically states facts but insinuates something different, is that fair game? Is that fair to do that?
Well, you know, stating the facts, I think, are obviously something that is done all the time. And if someone wants to take, the salary that I got over 24 years that's comparable to other mayor's salaries of cities similar size in Arkansas and wants to do it in a way that, you know, that they think appears to be, combative to their opponent, then facts are facts. And that's what we did in our ad, and apparently that's what French is doing in his ad.
Last question for you. We got about 30 seconds here. Can candidates run positive campaigns?
Sure they can. Sure they can. Absolutely. What do you think we did for 11 months? And we want to get back to that.
But it's not a positive campaign anymore. I mean, but can you run all the way through the finish line? Not you, but I mean, can a candidate do that in this day and age with what's out there and the way the apparatus is set up?
Well, it's difficult. I'll have to acknowledge that. I mean, we've got the Crossroads pack that's going to come in, and I'm sure next Tuesday is going to start adding ads that aren't going to be favorable to me. The DCCC, their independent pack, is adding ads right now that aren't favorable to French. So I think it's difficult, particularly when there are federal outside dollars involved. And I'd love to go to Washington and try to do something that minimizes that kind of impact. It's really distorting the ability of campaigns to really stay positive and talk about the things that we ought to talk about, like we did in North Little Rock and like I tried to do for 11 months, and I'm going to try to get back to as fast as I can.
All right, he's Pat Hayes. He's the Democratic nominee for 2nd District Congress. Thank you for being with us this
Thanks.
Morning.